credit cards are frowned upon. People want cash. You show them a credit card, they're like, nine.
We're Andre and Lisa, a married South African-Italian couple who have been traveling together for almost 20 years to more than 40 countries. Over the past year, we have traveled through 13 countries in Europe with our 20-year-old motorhome. In our last video, we were rapidly making our way south through Germany after leaving Denmark, where we made time to visit the thousand-year-old city of Lübeck and make some interesting discoveries along our route towards Würzburg. In this video, we explore Germany's romantic road. The route starts in Würzburg in the north and ends in the foothills of the Alps near the iconic Neuschwanstein Castle.
Good morning and welcome to Würzburg, Germany. Well, actually, we're about 4 kilometers outside the old center of Würzburg. Würzburg is the beginning of what's known as the German Romantic Route. Now, it sounds all very exotic, but this was actually a marketing term thought up, I think, in the 50s to sort of encourage tourism. And it's about a 400-kilometer stretch going through some historic towns, supposedly connecting old Roman route. But there's a lot of historical significance, so we thought we're making our way down through the last bit of Germany. We'll have a look around. So I'm gonna get the bicycle down and explore Würzburg a little bit. Probably gonna stay here tonight. This is a free Stellplatz. You can stay up to 2 nights. Pretty sweet.
Hand me the bike keys, please.
Where are they?
Okay, I'll come first.
Würzburg is known as City of a Thousand Church Towers or something, eh?
The City of a Thousand Churches.
Oh, and this is just a random one we just found, but...
And this one's pretty impressive, so this one doesn't even make it onto the map.
Nope.
Wow, St. Aldebaran. Right.
So, the story about the...
Ring Park.
Fledermosa.
Let me see.
I don't think the bats are out right now. You're out riding the train.
Wait. We've upgraded bike mic security a little bit. Extra security to deter all these naughty little thieves.
Ooh, what a nice bike this is. I'm gonna steal it.
Okay, drama queen. God, that's why you'll never get a job as an actor.
What do you mean I'm so good at acting? This is the residence palace. It's a Baroque architecture from 1720. Now you have to pay to enter the palace and you can do a tour that costs 9 euro a person, or you can just visit the beautiful palace gardens as well as the chapel for free.
There's a number of critical elements that was not destroyed in 1945, such as the self-supporting vault and some other fancy staircase thing. Okay? But we won't be going in because it's going to take a long time. It's a massive, massive place. Imagine what it looks like inside.
Yep. No, if we had time, I would definitely go inside.
This is like stop number one.
You can get an idea of the scale here. So this is actually the residence or the palace. All of these so-called court garden spaces has open and free access. Now there's time limits depending on the season, but still, you can come and enjoy the space. Aha. Look, we found a church. Even better, we found a very cool street. Look at this. All very confusing.
There are so many churches, you literally can't tell one from the other.
Look at all these church spires, all in the same place. We're standing at the bottom.
Whether you're doing the romantic route or not, I would definitely say put Würzburg on your list of places to come and see in Germany.
This is what we're here for. Zwiebelkuchen.
Today is the first day. It's a seasonal thing where they cook this. It's a yeast-based dough, so it's not like a flammkuchen actually. And obviously it's got onion and speck and cream cheese on it. So we see if we get a piece. How's your onion cake?
The onions are actually, I think, somewhat reduced or made sweet. They're cooked.
Very sweet.
And there's also a fairly subtle aniseed flavor. Not enough bacon, but it's delicious.
It's pretty interesting. Mm. But yeah, we got samples. And then we also got a whole piece. And we're sitting here at the square in front of the Marienkapelle. Are you feeling romantic yet?
This is an incredible start to the romantic route. If Würzburg is anything to go by, these cities along this route are going to be beautiful.
Lots of character.
I'm not really sure if Würzburg is supposed to be the beginning of the romantic route or whether this is the end. This is climate.
Odd choice of words. What do you say about not eating ice cream until we get heaty again?
Oops, yes.
Boink.
Boink. Pistachio.
Excellent, actually.
Excellent. It really is good.
We're going to walk across the bridge, check out the view from the other side, relax a little bit, have a drink, and that might be it for Würzburg, but we'll see. Better hurry, it's time to go out to state.
This is the ancient walking tour of the city.
Ancient?
But it's definitely not for the ancient.
This looks like a ride at a scary theme park.
It does.
There's even a picture of someone being killed, I mean falling off a cliff.
Really?
Yeah. You're inside the walls. Boom.
Okay, now we're on top of the world.
This proved to be a really nice stop. 3.5-4 kilometer cycle to the center. To make it better, there's actually free services here as well. Water's paid. So you would connect your hose there, put your coin in, boom, off you go. Here's a service point for cleaning a cassette. And then you can also dispose of your grey water here. And there's actually even electricity, also paid, I'm guessing by kilowatt hours. We're moving on from our first stop at the romantic route. Got a few shopping stuff to do today, so we'll pick you up later.
Bye, Würzburg!
We decided to stop at this place called Utinger. It's a little town right on the river, and it's just so peaceful and beautiful here. Gives us a bit of time to relax, but hopefully we can find a path along the river to enjoy the space of it.
This is nice. I'm actually really glad that you said we should look for something else, something nicer. This is beautiful. So much better than a parking lot. Sometimes it's just worth it to be in nature, even if it's only for a few hours.
The fee is €8 to stay here per night. Is there electricity available? I think it's
quite cheap. It's extra.
€3 to pay for it. And then water, there's a machine there, €1 for about 160 liters. You pay by EasyPay app, or there's some dude that comes around apparently around now. We'll see. We'll see. Well, I'll tell you what. If you play your cards right, you might be able to take a quick swim, yeah.
Goodbye, Otinga. was a pretty cool stay.
Short and sweet, the weather's a little bit shoop this morning, so no swimming in the river. That's quite actually busy this morning, eh? This little town of Uttinger was virtually destroyed on the 23rd of February 1945 in the Allied bombing raid. 199 people died.
Oh wait, before you carry on with your story, how cool is this cool thing?
That was a sort of a way to promote the brewery here. Piling in here today. Your story's all stat. Anyway, we're on our way to Nordlingen. Just have to find...
Ooh, we need to put in fuel today.
Diesel is not going to break our banks. 227.
Ow! How many kilometers can we still do?
Exit the roundabout.
Very, exotic parking we got here. Now, believe it or not, this is where we were supposed to be last night, and I'm not sorry about our decision. Now, this is a free parking lot and people are overnighting here. There's no prohibition signs. Very easy walking access to, where are we?
Nordlingen.
Okay, now Nordlingen's got quite a history. It's actually over 1,000 years old. It's one of three remaining German cities with an intact city wall.
If you walk all the way around, it is only roughly 3 kilometers, so it's really cool that it's a small city that you can get all the way around.
This is not a great spot to do this chatting, so okay, let's go to the city center and we can talk a little bit there, because I always see a city logistics.
And I have another really exciting fact about the city.
Save it.
I'll save it. Imagine that you live right against the ancient city wall. Not only just against it, this is your garden and your house is built up right against it.
Yeah, you have weird people walking at your backyard with a camera in their hand. Well, you know, they say, oh, let's break this stupid wall down and build something modern.
Than having a fully intact city wall around the town, Nordlingen was in fact built in an impact crater 15 million years old and 25 kilometers in diameter. The meteorite hit with an estimated speed of 70,000 kilometers per hour and left the area riddled with an estimated 72,000 tons of micro diamonds.
Ooh.
How cool is that?
Okay, look for diamonds quickly.
Unfortunately, these micro diamonds are not exactly jewels. In fact, you
can't even see them.
In fact, they are in many of the stones with which the buildings are built.
Okay, time to go into the church. There's some random dancing, practicing dancing. So I guess this is for some other event later. Oh, Lisa got distracted like in 5 seconds.
What are those things? That looks like it's something that must be traditional.
Apple cake? Which one? The balls?
Rotenburger Tauberkugel.
Okay, God. Germany. Interesting phenomenon we found in only Germany is credit cards are frowned upon. People want cash. You show them a credit card, they're like, nine.
I'm going to Google what it is.
A credit card is a piece of plastic that we use to do electronic financial transactions with.
Auf Wiedersehen, Nordlinger! Just in time as well, because the rain has come down. Travel a little bit further along this romantic road,
yeah,
and find ourselves a spot for the evening.
Now, if you're watching this channel expecting us to have a firm and fixed itinerary and everything's going to happen according to plan, well, then you're watching the wrong channel.
Well, we always have a great plan. It just never goes according to plan.
At the beginning of the video, we said we're going to sort of follow the romantic route. And we did sort of. But now we're bailing. And we have a reason for it.
Hey!
Good morning. We want to take advantage of the fact there's no big trucks on the motorways in Germany on Sundays. And we want to cover a couple of hundred of kilometers because we want to go to a country we haven't been to.
Yay, new country!
But it's probably quite obvious. So that means we're going to skip out on the last famous destination of
Fussen and the new Neuschwanstein Castle. Okay, I know I butchered that name completely. I'm not even going to try again to get it right.
Neuschwanstein.
New Schwanstein Castle.
It's a very famous castle that marks off the end of the romantic route. We want to go past there, but it's Sunday, so it might be busy. And it's going to mean about a 4-hour, 5-hour detour, which we don't really want to do today. Guys, our next video will be on our next little tiny short. Oh, the joys of filming in public.
There's always somebody. I'm surprised no one's cutting the lawn this morning.
Sunday. Quickly for someone else. So if you guys want to see what we have to do for our next video, please hit the subscribe button, smash that like button. From there, we're still heading into Italy and we got a lot of good stuff planned. Thanks for watching as always, guys. We'll catch you next time.
Ciao, ciao.
Bye.